Friends, welcome back to our interview tutorial. In this video, we are going to discuss about different types of partitioners in Spark with some examples. Let's go and see that. Many people know only two types of partitioning in Spark. One is range and hash. But actually it is four, as you know very well about range and then hash and round robin and finally single partitions. All these four we are going to see with some examples in this video. For this use case, we just take only 10 records for your easy understanding. So here you can see the data actually. It will be A to E values will be repeated twice in our ID column and values 1 to 10 is available. Each value will be splitted with 4 partitions. Those 4 partitions values we can validate based on Spark partition ID columns. Let me see the examples of range partitioning first. We can use the data frame dot repartitions by range of the column. So we know very well ID column have unique values which is repeated from A to E twice. So now we can see the explain plan, how it is created. In explain plan, you can see the range partitioning of the ID and ascending values. Now we can see the data, how the data represents. Here you can total 10 records, you can see this one. And each of them will be splitted and created based on the unique value of 5 A to E values. So it is creating 5 partitions here. Let me see another examples on range partitioning. The same transformation we can use it, but additionally we can provide number of partitions. Before the example, we just provide only the column names, but here we can provide the number of partition values as well. So based on that, we can see the experiment plan as well. It is generating the total range partitioning value and finally it will be converted into 3 partitions. As well as we can see the actual data, how it is provided from this transformations. You can see the same data is available, but actually it just created 3 partitions only according to what we mentioned in repartition by range values. Now let's see the examples of hash partitioning. So we can use the repartitions transformation and we can mention number of partitions with respect to the ID columns. So based on that, we can verify how many partitions we can create and with respect to the column name. Here hash partition will be applying the hashing algorithm. Based on the hashing values, it's just generate and storing it. Now we are going to discuss an interesting topic about round robin partition. So what it is? Whatever the data you're going to store it inside your environment, that is going to be read by sequence and create the number of partitions as you mentioned with randomly. It will not be following any sequence method. Wherever the data is available, it's just going to collect and shuffle it and create the partitions. Now let's see with examples. This round robin partitions we can create based on repartition transformation and we can mention number of partitions as well. You can see the explain plan, how the round robin is creating. So as well as the data, you can see this data will be created 3 partitions of the values, each of them in different values. We will not be assured this value should go for this one, something like. So randomly just select and giving to you. Next, we are going to discuss about single partition. Nobody noticed what is single partitions, but actually it is available in Spark algorithm. So single partition we can validate based on the transformations of select expression or whatever the transformation will give you the final single partitions values. Here you can see the select expression is just providing count ID as a total count. This is going to be referred. In an explain plan, you can notice exchange of single partition as created on top of ID columns. As well as the output, you can see that output will give you only one output because select expression just creating total number of records and partition ID as a 0 here. Now you are able to understand how partitioning working on Spark and what are the types of partition is available. Thanks to watching this video. Please provide valuable feedback in comments.